Hello, my name is Jack Butler, and today I'm going to be walking you through how I made my RGB lights review video. If you have not watched this before, this is basically me going through editing, lighting, color grading, etc., about the entire video process. I don't just go over those things. Of course, I do say some mistakes that I could be improving on, because we can all improve on something. Now, this does take quite a long time, so there are timestamps in the description below to make sure that you are finding the part that you want to see the most. Now, with that all out of the way, let's go to my desktop so you guys can see how I made the RGB lights video. Right now, this is where I'm going to be showing you guys how I made the set for the RGB lights video. So just to show you the initial setup, I'm going to have an image right here. This is basically what I wanted. I was going to take a higher quality photo of it, but I never got around to it, so that's unfortunate. But this is the setup. I had a yellow background and purple lights illuminating inside walls. I've been thinking of this idea for so long, and I really, really wanted it to happen. So how did I exactly make this work? So actually, in front of me is this. So right now, what you're seeing is me with the 120D and the aperture 672S. Both of them are daylight balanced, and my C100 and very scooted up, and some of the props I used during the video. Now, this was actually fairly difficult to set up because I actually didn't have a whole lot of stand space. Like getting the mic pole arm over here was actually fairly difficult, and it wasn't fun to figure that out. So, yay! So this is the general talking head setup. I did make a weird mistake, although I should mention this later, this is something relevant. So if we go back to this image, probably should have started with this. So in my first part, I actually had it crazy underexposed, and then I fixed it later. So like underexposed, exposed, and that was just by the setting and, you know, whatever, which is unfortunate. But yeah, so this is basically what it created after I boosted the settings. One difficulty I've been having with this lighting setup, or any lighting setup, is that my eyes are really black. So like, even though right here, this is pushed to 100%, like, not 100%, but like 70%, and it's fairly close. I could have probably scooted it closer, but it's fairly close. It's not enough to illuminate my eyes, and even when I've had it at 100%, it hasn't been enough. So just something that I need to think about more. The fill light didn't really do much. I kept it at like 10%, so that wasn't all that great. I probably could have boosted that up a bit more. The shadows here are not distracting. It's just that overall, I felt like I didn't have enough light. But how did we get the purple here? And it doesn't really touch me either, so how did we get the purple? Because that's just the standard, you know, setup that everybody has. Let's go back to the new folder. Not the new folder. That's not what I wanted. Photography, BTS. Alrighty. So, I didn't take a picture of it, but I also had the Luxley Viola on right over here. It's super bright. It's way too close to the wall. Definitely should have flagged it or like did something with it. But yeah, I have a Boltzmann, and this was actually fairly difficult. I had a Boltzmann light at full power hitting the light here, hitting the side here. And just because of the type of purple I wanted, it was dark, but it still looked pretty good. I probably could have kept it just the same. Like I probably could have not had this light and probably tried to make it more downwards, but it gets the door, it gets everything here, and that is the power of having a light that is strong with a gel. Even though I said I didn't like using gels, here I am using a gel because I had to. I have no other RGB lights because I used the rest to make the background yellow. So let's go back here. So I don't show it, but also like, so I don't show it, but I have also a light up top, which is the LifeX light, that is shining yellow downwards. And I thought that might have been enough, but yellow doesn't work well in these sort of situations. So I have a gel on my aperture on one of my Aputure LEDs and it's shooting in the back. And then I also have my Yongno RGB light shooting just to add some fill. And it took all of that to create a pretty dark background. Like it's not that great. And I was hoping that I'd be able to have one more light to create a hair light for myself, but this was decent enough. It's just I just this was not enough light. Yellow is such a hard color to work with. But yeah, I basically just placed him out of frame, got the yellow. That's really all I wanted. If it was possible to get a really soft yellow light to illuminate that area, it'd probably be better than all these harsh sources. But yeah. But here I am with the gel again. I just sort of stuck it here. No real reason to. No, like I could have probably attached it some better way, but yeah, this is what I meant by they're a pain. Like my entire experience, like trying to deal with these gels and them making noise and having to find ways of placing them on different light sources, was a pain. But yeah, all that illuminates this talking head scene. It didn't take a whole lot of thought. The concept I feel like was still really, really strong. So the concept of having the purple outlines and the yellow inside, two contrasting colors that are it's pretty popular. And kind of taking a twist on my old color scheme, which was this one, which was using the purples and yellows in highlights and shadows and doing it naturally, I think showed a way of making myself look like I've improved, which I have, but you know, it's maybe not the most convincing way, but I thought that was the main reason why I wanted to use this specific setup for this talking head scene. But besides that, let's go into editing and it's just some small things about it that I did. So, editing, yay, editing. This is my entire timeline. Yay. Nothing special. I did nothing special with the editing. Talking head, cutscene. Talking head, B-roll. Talking head, B-roll. Talking head, B-roll. And sure, you can say that for a lot of videos, but like in particular, my flow of editing wasn't affected all that much by this project. I didn't have to change anything that made it anything about it particularly special. I will note though that some of the effects I put on my talking head part was a little bit much. I was going to use After Effects to scale up all my footage. But I just didn't, and I don't know why. I use Sharpen. Looks too sharp. Like, it looks so artificially sharp. Like, I don't know if you guys can tell. But yeah, I'm just gonna turn on the Sharpen filter on, off, on, off, on, off. Yes, it does look a little better, but I think that it genuinely harms how it looks, especially since we're working with so many colors that is definitely making it look a bit more video-ish than filmic. And I do this for all of my B-roll. I do sharpen 20 or 50, and I just think that it's just a little bit too much. One thing that I did with the and this is getting to the audio portion because I did nothing special with the editing here in general. Like, you know, not even this was all that great. So the audio is something actually in particular. So I added on a bunch of effects and I put a compressor, EQ, and noise removal, which is something I was doing with some of my freelance projects that I learned about, and it worked fairly well. And here I feel like my audio was already recorded so poorly that I ended up trying to save it with this very boomy sounding, like, listen, just listen to it. So using colored lights, I can achieve that color contrast right on set. So, using colored lights, I can achieve that color contrast right on set. It sounds edited. And that's maybe biased because I've edited the video myself and nobody's really had any complaints about it out of my friend circles, but I do think that it's something that I if I recorded better, these settings would have been great. Using compression on your audio makes it just sound better. Even if it's just a little bit, just evening it out, making sure that it all works okay is good. The audio part of this is just good. That is how it should be. Now, if we look into color grading, the color grading was actually fairly Interesting. Let's go into this window over here. Oh, right. I don't have them like connected anymore. Like I'm recording with two screens, so this actually makes it a little bit more difficult because I don't want to. Yeah. So if we look at this little window over here, let's go into Film Convert Pro. So obviously I have my normal settings. I always have it, my temperature at 5600. I don't know why. It's always worked for me, even though technically the aperture 120D is recording uses a six, I think it said 6000 temperature. So like actually, what happens if I change it? If I change it to this, yeah, it's not that different, but it makes a tiny bit of a difference. But yeah, I used FJ8543VD. If I going through the other color options, this was the only one where I thought the purples looked really good. All of the other ones are just like way too like light. Like this one I considered for a bit, but they look too blue. Like it looks, the issue with using some of these film stocks is they sometimes looks too blue. And this one, it was VD. This one I thought had the purple that I wanted without it making it look blue. But all these other options I played with, and this one just happened to be the best. I didn't do anything with the midtones, shadows. I just added some basic highlight, low light, or highlight and shadow recovery. Not anything special. 120, added that. And I believe that I only added a little bit of stuff in the Lumetri color. Let's see. I think I did an HSL secondary. Yes, I did do an HSL secondary. Let me go actually into color and show you guys that. And this is actually on one screen. So let's go into the HSL secondary. So on my face, I did add orange. This is with it. This is without it. Not that big of a thing. I did it mostly to correct my skin tone, to make it just look a little pop just a little bit more, make it look a little bit more human because I was working with a lot of unnatural colors and that they th those were have on my face and it did not look all that great. But yeah, in terms of color grading, that's pretty simple. I basically boil it down to a formula, which is contra well, obviously the regular color correcting, but I'm trying to make these images look as good as possible first before I do anything else. So, makes that pretty easy. So this is going to be the biggest part. Which is kind of why, like, I kind of saved it for last this time. I'm going kind of out of order. I don't really have a great organizational system, for this little series that I do for myself. But of course, B-roll is very important for every tech review. So let's go through the B-roll shots, as I've already kind of went in depth on the talking head part. So B-roll, this is some old videos from my other channel, Megamon Studios. When I was testing out my T2i. It looks bad. These all look bad. I actually used a lamp here. So I used a lamp to illuminate everything here with my T4i. Garbage. Everything here is just I put tissues over my lamp here and try to make it soft. It was a pretty poor attempt on trying to make this look decent. And that video in general was pretty bad. Okay, so this shot is actually really, really cool, and I really, really like it. So I don't have one of those fancy spinning table things. I have my chair. That's the only object in this room that can spin semi-well, like I'm looking around and I don't see anything. So yeah, I had to use my chair for a spinning shot, and how I did it was you can kind of see my light over here. So I have a light making this part blue, so it's pure daylight. Not pure daylight, but it's like it's super pushed to the cool side to illuminate this part. I have another light on the second arm of the chair over here, and it's making it red. And I had this really neat effect that I have with my Luxley Viola shining below it, making this really cool and just very interesting. I'm gonna turn off the volume for that. Very interesting bokeh effect. And I don't know, like this is. It's really hard for me to get macro shots because I don't have any macro lenses, but this is kind of like the closest I get to it. And I really like this. I used my chair creatively and I used a lot of color contrast. And with, by the way, without this light here, this looked really bad. But just adding that little bit of extra light made this scene look a lot better than it probably should, had any right to. I thought this was a good shot. I don't know if you guys agree, but this shot made me proud. I also used this in a photography thing with my 17 to 55 millimeter. It looked pretty cool. This is boring. I literally just changed my lights, and also you can see how much of a slob I am. Like that's that shot. It's literally just the lights on my ceiling and me bumping up the ISO to God knows where to see everything. Nothing special. From my Blue Yeti review. All right, this shot. So, fun fact, I actually used my 120D for most of these shots, and it was crazy moving this big ass light around. I had it lighting my whole hand here. And what I wanted to do was rack focus. What I wanted to do was like rack focus to the light not working, but you know. But yeah, it's just the whole light is on this phone and then nothing else is illuminating in the background. I don't know. I thought it added a neato crowd. I probably could have added a backlight to the phone on the opposite side. I did have enough space for that. That probably would have made this pop just a little bit more, but I did want that other light in the background to be somewhat of a focus. I should have rack focused, but yeah, that B-roll shot completely lit by 120D and it looked fantastic. It's just straight up. This is from a behind the scenes little thing. That's all that is. This shot is terrible. This was me just try I had so many different ideas for this shot. So it's lit in a very boring way. Like it's just like, yay, light. Oh, no light. I wanted to make it look as natural as possible to make it look normal, but I don't know. This it's just like it's boring. I wanted to have a picture like a sped up like time lapse of me screening in, screening out, screening in, screening out. But I wasn't able to. So that shot's boring. It also was fairly difficult to get because of my computer monitor getting in the way. Oh, this was fun. I literally ran out of ideas and I just had it like spit around. But also, like, what's really interesting about this shot is that I had my Canon C100 in my hands with the seven, yeah, it was the 17 to 55 millimeter, and I just had it in my hands with the Atomos recorder, and my shotgun microphone. So I just had this huge ass camera, and like if you saw me walking down the street with this and holding it up like I did, you'd think I was crazy. It's just like really, really like I want these cinematic vlogs, so I'm gonna get a cinema camera and put it in my hands. But yeah, that was. That was fun. This shot was pretty neato. I had to actually figure out how to do this with my tripod, and it wasn't not that interesting, but you know, I just tried to figure it out with my tripod to try to get a spinning shot. I really do need to get a slider or something because it's just like a simple rotation. I think it looked cool. It took me a while to decide on the colors as well. This shot took me so long. I knew I wanted to use. So this is actually from a show, March Comes in Like a Lion, that little background. That is from March Comes in Like a Lion, and I knew I wanted to use the part where it has all the bubbles, and for like an interesting background, but it took me forever to get this light the way I wanted to, or even like get it in the scene the way I wanted to. I tried so many different ways. I had a stand. I tried to use a stand, didn't look okay. Tried to make the light itself purple, like swing out. Didn't work. Tried to have it drop in, didn't work. So I ended up just like, zwoop. I think it worked pretty okay. It was just really funny to see like have struggled so much with this shot and try to think of how it would work. But hey, I got it. I was gonna use my smaller TV that you might have seen in the talking head scene earlier. That's on my desk. That didn't work. It was just too small. But yeah, I just have a purple light facing it, and this is all on my bed too. So every time I took a step. The lights were about to fall, so that was fun. This shot, 120D on the floor, it looks so decent. Like I don't think you guys understand. Like just having this huge ass light, super close, super soft, just shining down on the floor made everything look super good. Didn't even need to try. Also, taking this apart, I've done it so many times. It does also, it barely affects anything. Like, I don't know. Like, I've taken apart so many times. This shot, I had to clear out my entire row of cameras and lenses just to get this shot. I have it on my shelf. Annoying. This is also another part where I wish I had a slider. I have a blue light off to the side. I think I had my aperture, my newest aperture small LED light on the left side, and I just had them connect. I was thinking of using something else to like light the front more, but it wasn't entirely necessary. Here, I also had the 120D super close to the light. It took me a while to get the exposure correct because that 120D has a lot of light, and I think I was at like 15% light, and it for a native ISO for the C100 is 850, and to get the shallow depth of field, like it took me a very long time to get like all of this situated, but it looks cool. I zoomed in a bunch. I tried to use the 17 to 55 millimeter lens as much as possible. And I think I succeeded. I zoomed it all the way 50%. Looks great. Looks super sharp. I wish I could have lit this part a little better. That's about it. This shot was also me trying to figure out what the hell else to shoot in the background. I literally just saw a blanket, and there you go. This did also take me a little bit longer than it should have. I was trying to position the lights so it would make the blanket look like it wasn't blue to begin with. But yeah, I had a red light shining all the way down, and I was hoping it'd have a stronger effect on this light, but it didn't. But it ultimately made it look at least different than the other shot, so that's something. This shot is really funny. So everything in the background is Tigami Bachi because I wanted to do a blue purple thing, and above the light, Luxley light is actually, I have an entire other light like above here, so it's on top of the books. So on top of the books is a huge light just shining purple down in the middle of this, and I did it all on my bookshelf. I just got a bunch of books, put them together that match the color scheme I wanted, and bam, bibbly bam bam, done and over with. It was pretty cool to see me do that. I was just reminded of using lights top down and it shining down on things to make it soft or make it look interesting. Luckily, it worked out. Looks pretty cool. This shot, I made a whole BTS video, links in the description below. Or actually, you know what? I can do a card. Here's a card. Here you go. There you go. You got it. You got the card. I'm using the 120D and the aperture softbox for this, and it looked so cool. This was my last shot of the entire thing, and I was running out of ideas super fast. I didn't know what to cover this cut with, and this was like a stroke of genius. I pulled off like the thing, put it up. Looks really cool. I don't know. It's just like it's so unusual. It's such an unusual look, and it's very different from what I normally do. It's very monochrome, and I don't know. I think it looks really cool. Just a reminder to use everything in your environment to make something look interesting. Sometimes it doesn't turn out okay, like the blankets, but sometimes it turns out fantastic. I loved using the softbox as a B-roll centerpiece, and I just love it. This could have been communicated better, maybe. It's just a shot of a wall. This shot, again, one actually, yeah, no, this was the 120D at super low power, and I wanted to show the background changing colors, but it ended up just being on my hand. But yeah, that shot. I still had the 120D set up. I don't know why I had it set up for all of these. Like, I just didn't want to put it away. I could have done this with like less powerful lights. Seizure warning. Had a lot of fun with this. Pretty basic shot. Wanted to use my table as texture and have it lit just with this light. Lots of darkness in this episode, and it made me realize how like good the C100 is in slightly lower light conditions. Just adding a little bit of contrast, getting rid of that noise. Looked super clean. I thought I had pretty good low light results. Even though like these aren't properly lit. And this shot reversed it. I tried to bring out some more blue and orange look, but it didn't turn out that way. It just, yeah. I thought the bokeh on this light looked really interesting, so that's why I did the shot. I also had to do this by hand. I don't have a small enough. This was like by my bedside. Like this is right in front of me, so I had to dress this setup too. Like, I had to clean so much around this. But yeah, I was hoping to have more orange and blue background. Maybe I could have added a split tone. But yeah, those were all the B-roll shots. And now, finally, I'm gonna go on to my mistakes and what I could have fixed. So things I could have fixed with this entire thing was definitely getting it done before this room was occupied. I had to ask people if I could use the kitchen for this, and it took me a while to set it up. And my script was memorized somewhat, and that's just one issue that I'm having with creating this episode personally. I have to memorize all the lines. I don't have a teleprompter, even though it definitely would help. I do not have a teleprompter for these, so it makes it very difficult for me to get the lines right as exactly how I wrote them. I wrote this in a very complicated manner. When I'm writing, I come up with all these words and ways to say things differently every time, and I don't think it's terribly successful for how I want to speak. Luckily, I still make it sound natural somewhat, but coming from my acting days, it's not dialogue. It's a review, so when I'm writing it, it sounds different in my head than how I say it spoken out loud. Even though I do speak them out loud, when I'm reading it, it makes sense. But yeah, I just missed opportunity there to memorize the script a little bit better. Definitely should get invest in a try in a teleprompter at some point. I do think that overall my execution of this idea with the lighting was pretty decent, but I really wanted it to look different. Like in my head, it looked a lo the purples looked a lot darker, and I think the only way I could have done that was to paint or use cloth. So definitely something to keep in mind. Even though I think this looked generally good, I think it could have used a little bit more darkness. Because I'm the darkest, like my hair is the darkest thing in the frame, and I wanted the background even to be lit with purple, but like a dark purple. And I don't know how to do that. But I still think it looked pretty decent. The lighting and sharpening definitely could have been reduced. I have over-sharpened this image like to hell. Like it looks so unnatural, especially my hair. And if you're watching this on a TV or a monitor that's not properly calibrated to not have sharpness in it, it probably looks like absolute garbage, especially in 4K. It's already 1080p. The sharpening is not helping it out. I should have done a detail upscale preserve instead of just going with the sharpening. Just not great. Some other things is obviously the audio. I think I had the microphone actually almost too close to me, even though it did sound pretty good. When I was monitoring it on set, the reverb in this room was just too much. So I either could have set up a bit more barriers for noise, or just like put a blanket on the table to make at least some of the refractions go away. But it was just the space that I had. I was almost thinking of doing voiceovers for this entire review, but I realized that would be difficult because of my way of speaking. But yeah, overall, I do think this turned out pretty okay. I do like it. I do like how my B-roll in this episode, and I do really, really like the concept of getting all these RGB lights just sort of out of the way in these small, tiny reviews. Yeah, I just need to do better at not just planning. It's always planning that bites me in the ass. I need to get better at planning, memorizing my script, and making sure that the script sounds natural. Also, like executing on my ideas a little bit stronger. I think if I went a little bit more full force into it, it could have looked just a little bit better. And also, my audio is garbage. Should have definitely had better audio. But yeah, that's about it. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did watch all of this, you can obviously watch this review and many of my other reviews in my channel. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. It might be another behind the scenes video. I'm not exactly sure. It might be another behind the scenes video, might be a review. I don't know. I don't do this full time. I don't make money off of this, so I don't know. But I'll see you guys whenever.